starting early Sunday as Isaac approaches the vicinity of South Florida. New information, storm information. Surge section for southwest coast. Wind sections. Areas affected. This local statement provides important information and recommended actions for people in marine interests in select locations and coastal waterlegs of South Florida. Watches slash warnings. A hurricane warning continues for the following locations: Coastal Collier, Mainland Monroe, and far south Miami-Dade. For marine interests, a hurricane warning continues for the local Gulf waters. A tropical storm warning and a hurricane watch continues for the following locations: Inland Miami-Dade, Metro Miami-Dade, and Coastal Miami-Dade. For marine interests, a tropical storm warning and a hurricane watch continues for the Atlantic waters south of Golden Beach and Biscayne Bay. A tropical storm warning continues for the following locations: Glades, Hendry, Inland Palm Beach, Metro Palm Beach, Inland Collier, Inland Broward, Metro Broward, Coastal Palm Beach, and Coastal Broward. For marine interests, a tropical storm warning continues for all of the Atlantic waters and Lake Okeechobee. Storm information: at 5 p.m., the center of Tropical Storm Isaac was located near latitude 21.3 north, longitude 76.0 west. This was about 410 miles southeast of Miami, Florida, or about 500 miles southeast of Naples, Florida. Storm motion was northwest, or 310 degrees at 21 miles an hour. Storm intensity was 60 miles an hour. Situation overview: it is vital that you do not focus on the exact forecast track. To do so could result in bad decisions and place you or those who are responsible for it greater risk. A general concern should be mainly for the likelihood of tropical storm force winds across South Florida, with the slight potential for hurricane force winds along the Gulf Coast and extreme south and southeast Miami-Dade County at this time. Should that potential be realized, it would materialize within 18 to 30 hours from now. Therefore, a hurricane warning remains in effect for portions of those areas. There is also the concern for significant flooding across portions of South Florida Sunday through Monday as the system approaches and passes by the area. Total rainfall amounts of 4 to 8 inches are currently forecast through Monday. There is the potential for much higher amounts if rain bands train repeatedly over the same area as Isaac passes south of the area. A flood watch will likely be needed for all of South Florida by Sunday. Isolated to scattered tornadoes will also be possible across all of South Florida, regardless of storm intensity. While a tornado is possible at any time from tonight, the greatest risk will be Sunday through Monday. Major coastal flooding is possible along the Gulf Coast. Low to moderate coastal flooding is possible along portions of the southeast Florida coast. Surf will continue to build tonight into Sunday, peak by Sunday night, then steadily subside Monday through Tuesday along the Atlantic beaches of southeast Florida. Along the Gulf Coast, surf will quickly build late Sunday night into Monday morning and peak by Monday afternoon. The combination of surf and onshore winds will result in life-threatening rip currents along with moderate to major beach erosion along the Gulf and Atlantic beaches. Precautionary slash preparedness actions: for those under a warning, now is the time to rush to completion preparations for the protection of life and property. Evacuate if directed to do so by local officials, or if your home is vulnerable to high winds or flooding. All coastal and marine interests in warning areas should complete preparations as soon as possible. If you live on a boat, make final preparations now and secure your vessel before leaving. Be sure to account for the possible closure of bridges and causeways. Regarding any coastal waters under a warning, small craft should remain in port and well secured. For those under a watch, continue with your preparations and listen for possible warnings. Regarding any coastal waters under a watch, small craft should return to port or seek safe harbor. Determine the best strategy for securing your craft. Closely monitor NOAA weather radio or other local news outlets for official storm information. Listen for possible changes to the forecast. For additional precautionary and preparedness information, please refer to the detailed recommendations relative to your location as further described by your local National Weather Service office and county emergency management. You can also go to ready.gov, readisouthflorida.org, floridadisaster.org, the American Red Cross at redcross.org, or your county emergency management website. Next update: the next local statement will be issued by the National Weather Service in Miami around 12 a.m., or sooner if conditions warrant.